In this video, we're going to have an overview of the diary within Clik Service. So all you need to do is click diary at the top left to get to the module. And then on the very left, we've also got the diary selected as the tab. So from here, we can see that diary that is shared between everyone within Clik Service. So this is all your users and whatnot, including the engineers. We can put a filter on there to say, like, whose diary do we want to see? So for example, I'm just going to see Tom's. Or I can see another person, so Oliver's here, for example. We've also got a filter of what items you want to see on the diary. So there's a big list of different things you can have, but for example, I might have, right, I just want to see the engineer bookings here with job engineers. I want to see diary items, and I want to see holidays as well. You can check those in there, then just hit OK. It'll only show those sort of item types on there as well. Now, it's one of the new features as well we have is saving different types of diaries. So you can see here, I've got a few different diaries saved. If I apply some filters, so I'm just going to say, right, let's just make one for, we'll make one for Tom. And then I want to save this diary to view in the future. I'm just going to go to the very top right, so save settings button there, and hit save as new diary. So I'll give it a name on here. So I'll just go Tom's diary. You can give it a color as well. Basically, it just gives you a little tab color on there, just makes it a bit jump out a bit more. And you can select who it's visible to. So it could be for everyone, just for you, or you want a selective department or group of people to view that as well. I'm just going to hit everyone for now because I'm not bothered who sees that. Cool. So then that diary tab will appear there from now on. Another thing to do as well, we can then delete that if you need to. You can change the details for this, so change the tab color. So the same window we saw when we're adding it, you can just change what that is from there as well. We can also go, okay, if I have any new sort of filters I've applied. So actually, I'm going to change this diary to be for, we'll say, let's save this just for particular. I might change it to be Oliver or whatever. If I hit this top right icon, just save user department choice there, it's just going to have that saved there. It has a little bit of text to tell you that you save that information there, that filter there as well. From the diary as well, we can actually just click onto jobs. So right now I can see here we've got a few jobs. If I just get rid of the holidays and put jobs in there as well as job bookings, so job engineers is jobs bookings. I can double click into each of these items. So if I hover over them, it gives you a bit of a breakdown as well. But if I double click onto that, it will jump into the job as well. On the right side here, we can have a different view for the diary. So for example, I might go, right, I only want to see this week's items. I want to see, we'll do timeline instead. So it's sort of a different view, just adds a bit of a timeline on there. Sort of have a shift around to see which one you like, you most prefer. Personally, I think the month one is best on the diary especially. But we've also got this one here, agenda. So it's a little breakdown of different items on each day. If I just hit there, for example, I'm going to say, right, actually, I'm going to change this to be for next, we'll say, I don't know, Friday. And you can see the little drop down, a little breakdown of what items have been booked out on there. So I can say, oh, Friday I've got this, but actually on Thursday we've got a lot of different jobs here as well. So yeah, have a mess about with that really and see which one you like. I'm just going to put it back to month for now. There's also this little settings cog. So if I hit that, if I hit appointment auto hype, that will just apply. It will make sure that all the text is visible. So for example, here I can see all the text is visible there, but if I just get rid of that, it's going to chop it up to fit in within that screen. But if I just want to see all that information, I'm just going to do all higher there. And then if I click into it as well, we can see what's on that particular day. There's also a little key as well here. So I go back to the month. There's a little key, so it just shows you what items are what colors they are effectively from here. So yeah, a little breakdown of what's going on here. There's also job statuses as well. So if the color is green, we've got that's a completed job, for example. We've got so that basically corresponds to your status colors. So if you have different status colors, it will change to the ones that you set up within your service. There's also a little pop-out window button here. So if you want to have this maybe on a screen, on a different screen or something like that, always visible, just hit that little pop-out and new window button there. We can change the order of the tabs that appears on the diary. So if I hit the top right icon and go tab ordering, I'll go, right, I'm actually going to put Tom's diary to the very top. So I'm just going to select the one I want, keep hitting that icon at the very top there, and it will shift them up to the very top there, and you can then go to the very left tab as well. So you can change the position of each tab if you want to as well. And it's also, if you do make any changes to any particular diary, you just need to make sure you save it by just going to the top right and go save view settings. The difference between these is the view settings is the way that the view works. So like the month, week, timeline, how if you want it to auto height, stuff like that on the appointments. But if I do save user department group choice, that will save the filters that you apply for each diary on there. So just make sure you press save on there if you do edit any of the filters on the on a diary. If I hit manage all saved schedules as well, that's basically gives you a little breakdown of each tab you've got in there, and I can double click into them and change the name for each one or change the color and who is visible to as well. And that's it for the diary overview.